Welcome, everybody, to a brand new episode of That's a Wrap. I'm Caboose.
I'm Andy the Answer.
And today, what we got for you guys here is our non-spoiler review of one of the upcoming DC films, that, of course, being Aquaman. Now, listen, we got a pretty awesome experience this film.
We
have to send a huge, huge thank you to Warner Brothers Pictures Canada for inviting us, first of all, to our local mall, Yorkdale, to check out the Octopus Throne, which was incredible. I loved it. They had an awesome display at Yorkdale. We got to hold tridents, which was badass.
It was impressive. That was awesome. I wanted to take that thing home.
So that was a lot of fun. And then on top of that, going to the actual screening of the movie, we got to check out the blue carpet premiere. And Patrick Wilson, who, of course, plays Orm, or the Ocean Master, was in attendance. And, of course, Yaya, who also plays Black Manta, was there as well. It was a fantastic experience.
Cool. We got to meet them. They were nice. They took some selfies.
Got to meet Patrick Wilson. Got to get his autograph right here on this poster. That was incredible. I told him that Watchmen was a masterpiece.
Yes, you did. You threw that in there. And there were some amazing cosplayers down there, too. It was just a great experience all around.
It was a great experience. So thank you so much to WB for inviting us out to all this. We had absolute blast. But all right.
Yes.
Let's jump in and talk about Aquaman. Like I said, we got to see it. We're going to give you our non-spoiler thoughts here. First of all, DC's hit a home run.
Yeah. Well, the thing I want to say, first of all, is I can't wait to do the spoiler review for this. Although this is a non-spoiler, I've got a lot to say about this film, and man, it was a home run for me.
That is so awesome to hear from your side of the table.
Yes, because you know I'm the DC hater over here. But no, I mean, they have really hit a home run with this movie.
Yeah.
It easily comes to the top of my list for a DC movie. Yeah. I got to tell you right now.
For sure, for you, I know, because you're not a big fan of a lot of DC movies. Yes. But I'm so happy to hear that you loved this, because honestly, James Wan really did his job here. It is so damn good. The action is incredible. What I love about superhero movies is when there's a scene or two where they really show you the power of the hero.
Yes.
You know, in Man of Steel, we have that scene in the bar where the guy tries to push him and he doesn't budge.
Yes.
In Captain America, we have the scene on the boat where Captain America just lays out all those dudes.
Yes.
Aquaman has that in this film.
And we get it in the first 30 minutes.
And it is so good. Badass. It is
That's an excellent point, Caboose, because you got to set that tone. You got to show how badass your character is.
Yeah.
And they do it so properly. I was actually thinking, you know, the first 30 minutes of this film is one of the most explosive 30 minutes of a comic book movie for me that I can remember. Civil War is one of those for me, but this, like, I'm telling you, the first 30 minutes, it just set the tone so perfectly.
Yeah.
I was like, this movie cannot falter. The first act sets the tone so beautifully. And I was telling you, Caboose, on the Uber ride home, that it's amazing what DC has done here. They took Jason Momoa, you know, kind of the surfer dude, and they made Arthur Curry Aquaman into him.
Yeah.
You know, they didn't take the character and then the actor had to fill the character role.
Right.
It's really interesting what they did here. They've done it beautifully because that's who Jason Momoa is.
Yeah.
We see him on film. We see him everywhere.
Exactly.
That's the type of person he is. Mm-hmm. A lovable guy. I mean, I was just floored by this movie.
Yeah, no, he does an incredible job in the movie. And, you know, you're right. Like, they really shape the personality of Arthur Curry and Aquaman and make it work with who Jason Momoa is.
Yes.
So, at the same time, you know, it's not just like it's Jason Momoa walking around. He very much fits Arthur Curry.
Yes.
And a lot of what the character is in the comics and, you know, the ideals of that character are here. So don't worry, it's not just Jason Momoa in an Aquaman costume.
Yeah, you get Aquaman, there's no doubt about it.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And honestly, like, the action is next level. Like, you can definitely see a lot of the flavor from Furious 7, where James Wan directed that. He's taking a lot of what he learned with the action there and applying it to Aquaman. The fight scenes are awesome.
Yeah, he's got great action sets in this movie. I mean, like I said, it starts right from the beginning. The slow-mos with James Wan's note, or there is some great slow-mos.
Yeah.
One in particular with Aquaman that everybody is going to love. But it was an incredible movie from beginning to end. It's always difficult when you're doing a non-spoiler because you can't. I don't want to reveal a thing to the fans here, because they're really going to enjoy the experience of this movie.
And I also love, you know, James Wan, he comes from a background of horror films. You know, he's directed the Saw films, he's directed The Conjuring, you know, Insidious, and he has his stamp of horror in this film. You know, we know the trench from the comic books. It's a really dangerous place of the sea, and that is where James Wan really got to shine and provide his own stamp on this movie. And I think what I love the most about this movie is there was no interference. They were like, listen, go make your movie. And that's exactly what James Wan
did. That's what you gotta do. You gotta let the director do their thing. And I mean, okay, so let's talk about a lot of the positives, then we can get into very minimal negative.
Yeah.
The costumes.
Incredible.
My goodness. I mean, wait till you guys see Black Manta's costume. It is up there, top five for a comic book character movie's costumes. I mean,
almost all the costumes in this movie are up
there. And I'm happy that they're not CGI. Me and you had talked about that.
Yeah, they're all practical.
They're all practical. It was just incredible. It was a very different movie because the underwater, you understand they're almost talking like they have a little bit of water like in their voice.
Yeah, yeah.
You could tell that this is a difficult movie to make.
Yeah.
And from the beginning, Patrick Wilson came out and talked to the audience, and he said that.
Yeah.
He said that, you know, we didn't have the technology to do this before. That's why this movie didn't come. Now
exactly.
we have it. You know,
exactly.
It was a very, very good point. And I remembered when he said that at the beginning, because this is not easy.
Yeah.
So I mean, you know, some of the negatives that we get into, the CGI is definitely rough at one point.
For sure.
But a CGI is never going to really make or break a movie for me, especially this one. It must be very difficult to do.
Yeah. No, I agree with you. I think definitely if we're going to go into negatives, my biggest problem with the movie is there is a lot of CGI.
Yes.
But you know, just what you were saying, what Patrick Wilson had mentioned at the beginning of the screening, right before we got into the movie. This is a very difficult movie if you want to be faithful to the comics, you know, and have the movie be underwater to do it properly and have it look incredible.
Yes.
There's going to be some wonky CGI, you know, there's going to be some things that very obviously look like green screen.
And even on land. That
definitely.
Even on land, there's some parts that don't look too great.
There's some rough green screen moments. There's some rough CGI moments. But just like you, that's stuff for me where like, I understand it. You know,
yes,
in order to make this movie the way that it is, it has to have CGI. You know, and it has to have an excessive amount of it.
And there has to be some rough patches. Know? All the actors and actresses across the board did a wonderful job here. I'm talking the villains, Mera. Oh my God, the dad was even good. Nicole Kidman was great.
Yeah.
They all did a fantastic job. The villains had a good motive, especially Black Manta.
Yaya is Black Manta.
He did a great
job.
Honestly,
I wouldn't even
his hatred was real.
Yeah, he was so real. He had an incredible motivation right from the start of the movie, and he is so good in the movie. Honestly, my favorite character, my favorite part of Aquaman was Black Manta. From the costume design to the character motivation to the acting, the performance put on by Yaya, it was awesome.
It was awesome, man. It really was. It's really hard to nitpick a lot of things with this movie, which I do sometimes with DC movies, but it was...
I think if there's only one other thing that I could pick out that was a bit of a negative is there's a lot of dialogue from characters in the movie where it's exposition, you know? Mm-hmm. The entire point of the scene, the entire point of the conversation between the characters is to give exposition on something. And it's not just one or two times where that happens. There's like a lot of times where that happens, you know? A character is just solely there to give you exposition on something. And I get it. We're new to this world. We have to be introduced to a lot of new things. So they have to give us some backstory to it. But it was a bit excessive.
I got to tell you, Caboose, I was perfectly fine with that. And I told you that once again on the Uber ride home. It was just great. They didn't do this long, drowned out origin story. They didn't because he's already in this world from Justice League. You know, so it was, I was fine with a little bits of the backstories that they did. They quickly did it. They didn't waste time. They didn't bore us. For me, it's all about pace. Always about pace of the movie. And this one, from beginning to end, it's got a great pace.
Yeah, I definitely wasn't bored. You know, there's some good humor in there, too.
Great humor.
Which is always such, it's great to have humor in these comic book movies. Because at the end of the day, you know, they're comic book movies.
Yes.
Like, you've got to have a little bit of fun with it. And that's one thing I got to praise Aquaman the most for, is it doesn't try to be the perfect film with, like, the great cinematography and everything. Like, no, it's like, this is unapologetically a comic book movie.
Yes,
100%.
Yes.
And that is the best part about it.
And
for
I expected humor because we see it from Jason Momoa all the time when we see him on film, YouTube, anything. The guy is just a lovable, funny guy.
Yeah, I know.
It's
just his...
And his humor is very timely and really good in this movie.
Well, I mean, I don't know. We really can't praise the movie enough. Surprisingly enough, I had more complaints than you did.
Yeah, yeah. You know, you did. I'm telling you, I was for it. I was really thrilled. This is one I want to watch again. I was telling you, when this, you know, in way in the future, when it comes out on Netflix, this is one of those movies I will watch over and over again because I thoroughly enjoyed it.
And while we won't spoil anything, it is worth mentioning because DC movies don't do this very often.
Yes.
Stay for the credits.
Yes.
Stay for the credits. But all right, let's give our rating out of 10 now. What are you going to give Aquaman out of 10?
I'm telling you, I got to give it a 9 out of 10.
Wow, a 9.
It's up there. I can't see anything negative that people could say.
This is going to be crazy because you have a higher score than me for a DC movie. I'm going to give Aquaman an 8.5 out of 10.
All right.
I mean, I did have a lower score, but I think we both love it just the same.
Yes.
You know, I just feel that there was some things that maybe detract from it that you didn't mind too much. But overall, we loved Aquaman.
We did.
And we had a great experience, first of all, going to that Octopus Throne at Yorkdale.
Yes.
And then, of course, checking out the blue carpet. But all right, now we're going to get to you guys. Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. Have you seen Aquaman yet? If so, what did you think? We want to hear what you guys have to say in the comments. And I'm sure you're excited to interact with the fans.
Yeah, I'll interact with the fans for sure.
Yeah, all right. Well, with that said, I'm Caboose.
I'm Into the Answer.
And you can click on screen to make your way to one of the other videos on the channel. Or you can click my logo to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Please follow me on Instagram and Twitter and like me on Facebook. Those links are in the description. Drop a like if you enjoyed. Leave a comment if you have an opinion. And subscribe if you're new.
That's a wrap.